He's one of racing's most influential figures, and at Flemington next week, Lloyd Williams might again capture turf's ultimate prize. The 83-year-old spoke exclusively with Tony Jones, reflecting on the city he loves, his adoration for Gay Waterhouse, and the loss of his great mate, Kerry Packer.
Given the Midas touch he possesses, Lloyd Williams could turn the murky Yarra into a river of gold. And as he enters another cup week, he might just strike gold again. But according to Lloyd, the biggest winner is our city.
It's a wonderful thing for Melbourne. You know, it's the homegrown event, isn't it? It's like the grand final.
Williams has two runners in the cup as he aims for an astonishing eighth win in the great race. Cleveland and Serpentine, the latter trained by Gay Waterhouse.
I think Gay is absolutely fantastic for anything in Australia. She promotes the country, she promotes her state, she promotes Melbourne, she promotes racing. You know, she's the best thing that's happened to the racing industry in my lifetime.
Lloyd's connection with Gay goes back a generation to her dad, the late Tommy Smith.
Trained my first group winner in 1969. He trained the first Melbourne Cup winner I had in 1981, Justa Dash.
And Justa Dash is going to win the Melbourne Cup.
Just as TJ Smith and Gay are regarded as legends of Australian racing, Lloyd Williams is rightfully regarded in the same vein. His influence on the sport goes beyond ownership.
I was very pleased with myself in 1990. I started the young members at the VRC. That was one of my early initiatives 30-something years ago. That's what the whole industry is about, whether it's football or racing or whatever it is. If you don't cater for the young people, you're making a huge mistake.
In the 80s, it was very much a Lloyd Williams-Kerry Packer partnership. The pair had a brotherly bond.
I miss him terribly because he was someone I spoke to every day of my life. And as you're aware, I was on that board with him for a long period of time. Now I miss him enormously.
But the Williams-Packer days aren't over yet. Lloyd and James Packer now share ownership of horses in Europe.
I said to James, I said, we've got to try and... while I'm still here, let's try and reinvent what we did with Dad.
The Williams-Packer partnership also saw the creation of Crown Casino. Lloyd was very much front and centre from the time it opened in its temporary digs in 1994 and then moving to the Crown we know now.
And I declare Melbourne's Crown Entertainment Complex officially open.
Although no longer part of the business, he still has a genuine affection for it.
What had happened, I think the connection with the city had fallen somewhat because of overseas players. And they're coming back very much part of Melbourne again. I noticed with their advertising, their promotion, etc., they're attaching to the Spring Carnival again, which is a great thing.
Lloyd Williams can look around this city knowing a great chunk of its construction came from his vision, but he's still very much about the future as opposed to the past. He's a healthy 83. With a healthy sense of humour.
To use a racing expression, every night I go to bed, I take evens, I'm going to wake up.
Tony Jones, Nine News.